Hello. This video explains how to submit change requests in My South Carolina Educator Portal, a secure website provided by the South Carolina Department of Education for educators and teacher candidates in the state of South Carolina. The portal is accessible on PC, tablet, and mobile devices, and its responsive design means that your device view may differ slightly from the PC screenshots used in this video. It has also been closed captioned, so please click the CC button to turn on captions. My SC Educator Portal is a new secure website for South Carolina educators designed and supported by the South Carolina Department of Education, also known as the SCDE. This new system allows educators to submit requests and upload documents directly into a secure online portal. As a South Carolina educator, you have access to both sites, ed.sc.gov/educators takes you to the Department of Education website. This agency webpage provides a list of quick links for educators, and there's a quick link to a website page called About My SC Educator Portal with a link to the actual portal. There's a lot of information available on the agency website. Just remember that the easiest way to find what you are looking for is to use the top-level search box and type it in. To access My SC Educator Portal directly, navigate to teach.sceducator.ed.sc.gov/. Once there, you will want to read the user acknowledgement and then click on I agree to acknowledge the terms of authorized use. Don't forget to bookmark the web URL for easy access to the site on future visits.
To request changes to your account/profile, click on the Requests button on the left menu. You will see two sections, New Requests and My Current Requests. Once you create a request, it displays in the Current Requests section with notifications until all actions have processed. To create a new request, navigate to the New Requests, Create New Requests section. Click on the Start button to choose the type of request you wish to submit. If you need to apply for a new South Carolina teaching credential, click Apply for Certification. For all other types of requests, click on Submit a Request. The Apply for Certification box is the option to use if you wish to apply for a new South Carolina teaching credential. Click on the Start button to choose the type of certification for which you wish to apply. Use the standard application if you are applying as a traditional program completer or an out-of-state educator. All possible options are listed on the screen in the drop-down box, and when you click on a selection, a brief description will display before you click to choose that type. Let's examine the choice of student teaching. When you click on that option, a description displays stating that this application type is for individuals currently enrolled in an approved educator preparation program seeking to complete a student teaching or clinical experience in a South Carolina public school. If this is the correct choice, then click on the Choose This Application button to begin the process. A window will open with a list of required actions in the process. Each step is a clickable button that will allow you to enter data or upload specific required documents. Notice that each button has a notification state that allows you to monitor progress. The Explain Status button lists the 5 notification states for requests in this portal. An orange awaiting review label means that the department is either waiting to receive or actively reviewing the necessary items to satisfy the requirement. A light gray NA label means not applicable and that you need take no action. A teal next up label means that the action will be needed in the future. A green on file label means that a requirement has been met and is on file with the Department of Education. A teal ready to start label means that the requirement is ready for the educator to visit and complete. The Send Documents button will return the user to the Send Documents section, as will the Send Documents button on the left menu. The Back to Request button will return the user to the Requests section, as will the Requests button on the left menu. All current requests display in the My Current Requests section of your profile landing page. All the examples shown here need additional information, so they display with a notification of not submitted. Let's look at the student teaching example. This request for student teaching shows that the certification application and fee payment are on file, but the criminal records review is awaiting review. Since requests cannot be submitted until all parts are complete, I'm a teacher can see that she has submitted everything needed from her and that she will need to check the status of her criminal records review at a later date. To create requests for anything other than apply for certification, click the Requests button in the left menu, then New Request and Submit a Request. Click the Start button and choose an option from the drop-down list. This list is extensive, so please read through all the options before deciding to use the General Request / Inquiry option. As we've said before, there are many types of change requests that one can make in this portal. Many relate to changes that happen annually, like educator experience, new degrees that advance your class level, and even changes to your name. Other change requests relate specifically to teacher renewal and your educator certificate. This video will provide the examples of add service or leadership field, add educator experience, submit a name change, and evaluate Read to Succeed endorsement requirements. For additional information on types of teacher renewal, please view the separate video on that topic. If you wish to make changes as a school librarian, counselor, psychologist, or speech-language pathologist, you should use the Add Service or Leadership Field option. This is also the appropriate choice if you wish to advance in leadership to principal, superintendent, or as a vocational, technology, or career center director. Once you start this type of request, you will need to complete and add the service or leadership field form and submit any transcripts of applicable courses and/or applicable exam results for review. To receive experience credit on a valid South Carolina Educator Certificate, you must provide a verification of teaching experience form completed by an employer's human resource or payroll personnel. The completed form may be submitted directly from the employer to certification@ed.sc.gov or uploaded by the educator using My SC Educator portal. The Office of Educator Services may also request an official description of the professional duties if unable to verify eligibility for teaching experience credit. It is recommended that applicants supply the supplementary documentation with the verification form to avoid processing delays. Choose the name change option to request a name change. You will be asked to input what name you have changed to, and you may include information to explain the circumstances. You will be required to upload supporting legal documentation for this request to be processed, and there are some set dates for when these changes occur each year. Authorize the request by checking the box and submit the request. The Read to Succeed Act requires that all certified educators earn the appropriate Read to Succeed endorsement for their field. There is specific information on the agency website about this endorsement and where it fits within renewal cycles. When you choose to submit an Evaluate Read to Succeed endorsement change request, you will be able to choose the category for which you wish to be evaluated: the basic requirement, literacy teacher, literacy coach, or literacy specialist. You will also need to submit a proof of professional development and or transcript. Those were a few examples of change requests. Now let's talk about supporting documentation. All documents uploaded to My SC Educator portal must have a related change request. Use the Send Documents button on the left menu to submit required documents. This page features an input box with a drop-down list feature. Click the down arrow on the Choose Document Type drop-down to open the list of documents and choose the type you need to submit. Supporting document types are specific and limited in order to correctly process through My SC Educator portal. Examine the entire list to choose the appropriate document type, and then click Add File to upload a PDF version of your document. Please submit only the necessary documents and ensure that they are in the PDF format. It is not necessary to resubmit documentation that is already on file, like your educator certificate. And there is a file size limit of 30 megabytes. When you have submitted a document that supports a change request, you will see an acknowledgement checkbox. You will not be able to submit your request until you check the box to acknowledge and authorize the request. If none of the options listed in the Submit a Request drop-down fits your need, then you can use the General Request Inquiry option. This will open a General Request form. This form should only be used if there is no specific form listed for the request that you are making. Please carefully review all the available options before choosing to submit a General Request Inquiry form. If you try to submit a request that seems duplicative, the portal will display a question box that says, "You already have a request of this type in progress. Are you sure you want to create a new one?" You can choose Yes, I'm sure, or Never mind. You may need to do this. Just remember to check your current requests in the My Current Requests section for any change requests that you've created and not yet submitted. This slide shows I'm a Teacher's Requests page and indicates that there is a General Request Inquiry that has not been submitted. She should either click the View Request button to complete it or delete it if no longer needed by clicking on the trash can icon on the specific request item. Once you have submitted a change request, you should monitor its progress regularly. Keeping your information up to date is critical, since years of experience, additional degrees, and any endorsements earned are listed on your educator certificate and affect your teacher pay rate. If anything on a certificate is not correct, check that you have submitted all required documents in the portal and for any notifications that indicate documents are in review or waiting on another action. Thank you for your interest in My SC Educator portal. This screencast covered change requests in the portal. To learn more, please view the other screencasts in this series.